What's happening, guys? Welcome to the next video for Classic Physiques Gym. I'm your host, James Barrows. Let's get to it.
Ombe sail, ombe tell you to run.
On the way, on the way.
Ombe to see, ombe to yawn.
Right then, guys, first exercise is seated calf raises. So as you can see, I'm putting my hands on my calves just to make sure that I'm getting a good connection with the muscle. And that just really helps me get a good pump in the gym. I'm making sure that I'm coming all the way down and all the way up at the same time. So yeah, this is one of my favorite exercises for calves, guys, to be fair. I really get a good pump, but more importantly, I get good contraction. So sometimes it's good to start the leg workout with calves, because you know what? We always get too tired when it comes to calves at the end. So it's nice to start with calves sometimes and then work our way over to our quads and our hamstrings after. I may do this once every maybe third or fourth leg workout, just because I feel like my calves need a little bit more development than my quadriceps or hamstrings or glutes. Right then, guys, so the next exercise is leg press. Now, my preferred method of this is bringing my feet nice and high, so my toes are literally just at the top, as you can see, and I'm pushing through my heel. And the biggest thing that you have to look now, I'm doing it time and attention. So as you can see, I'm not thrusting up and down, overloading the leg press. The days of doing 14 plates a side are long gone. No benefit of doing that, guys, really isn't. You know, do a lighter loading and get more of a contraction within the leg. So remember, the muscle adapts with what? With a stress. And when the muscle adapts with stress, it's being put under, it will build. So as you can see, I'm doing a fast repetition now. And that was followed, obviously following on from the slower repetitions and more deliberate. Changing the tempo of the set is something that a lot of people don't tend to do, but something that a lot of more people should do. Because remember, stress is the key for muscle growth. So mixing up the type of stress your body's under will increase the amount of muscle that you can potentially put on, if rest is good, if nutrition is good, and these other factors like stress, staying stress free. Okay, so let's have a little look what we're doing here now. Okay, so again, feet are fairly close together. I'm pushing through my heels, and that's my preferred method, guys. I'm not saying I would never change my stance up, but as a general rule, lock my toes up nice and high, feet shoulder width apart, and pushing through. So the next exercise is the H squat. So this is a new bit of equipment that I think you've seen before, guys. It's bang on, man. It's proper bang on. This is only one of three in the entire country. And as you can see, I'm doing a single leg variation here now. I'm getting a really good, see, I'm going just past 90 degrees, and this sort of range of motion can't be achieved sometimes during normal circumstances in a squat. So it's nice to work the muscles in a different plane of motion by doing this sort of way. Okay, so I'm just having a look now. And as you can see, I'm really getting a good contraction. My toes are just off the edge, which encourages me to push through the heel, which is very, very good for muscular growth as opposed to pushing through your toes. That's not really what you want to do. So I'm obviously making sure that my back's obviously flat, making sure my legs are in good position. And now, if you look at my technique now, what I'm doing now is I'm bringing my feet lower down, and I've actually done the exact of what I was doing before. I've actually put in my toes and I'm pushing through my toes. This is called a ballerina squat. So this is just another variation, guys, here. So this is something I really like to do. Push through the toes and your midfoot, bring your heels in, and go for it. So you've got two variations there. And as you can see, I'm going quite fast. This really stretches out the muscle fascia, which is the muscle tissue that you've got in your over your body, really. But I really get a good stretch on those quadriceps, and it really does burn. It's a good contrast to be pushing through your heel. Why not? But keep the loading lighter here, guys, because it's it is a bit more of a difficult technique. Okay, and getting down from the machine is always a difficult part as well. But you know, you got to do what you got to do. Just make sure you don't fall over. Okay, so moving on to the next exercise is the pendulum squat. This is a really good bit of equipment here, guys. Not many gyms have this either. We like to be a bit different here at Classic Physiques. And you know what, it's really heavy, but as you can see, the range of motion's, you know, very, very good. I can really get a lot of range of motion here, which is going to encourage muscular growth. So on a squat, to get that range of motion, 99 people out of 100 people would need to use the back a lot during the lift. But with a pendulum squat, you can literally just go ass to grass. That's what I call it. I call it A to G, ass to grass, and it feels great. You get a lot of muscular growth on this, and without your back being compromised. So I'm going to increase the load in here. This is a big set now, guys. 20 kilos a side, but it feels a lot heavier than this. I mean, this feels like a 120 kilo squat, 100%. The leverage system is fantastic. As you can see, I'll pop down, boom, out the heel. Pushing through the heels with this one, guys. You don't want to be pushing through the toes on this particular one with this particular loading. So this is probably the equivalent of maybe 120 kilo on the squat. But as I say, the loading goes through the entire leg, the leg, should I say, and not the back, because you know what? I'll be training when I'm 50 and having a bad back is not for me. So as you can see, pause repetition at the bottom, just for not a bit of banter, but just to really push that last sort of rep, really. It's a good job I didn't get stuck there like I have done in the past, but the safety's on, nothing to worry about. Defo feeling the effects after that one. That looked a lot easier than it actually felt, to be honest. So the next exercise I'm adjusting here, as you can see, is a lying, seated leg curl, should I say. This feels really, really good, guys. And as I say, I want to keep things heavy now. Make sure your toes are facing the ceiling, point them towards your forehead. Keep your legs locked into position, making sure that you're pulling with the hamstring. Hold on, and then just pull it all the way in, okay? 3/4 of the way up and all the way in. This is quite a heavy loading. This is stacking the loading now, so stacking the machine. So this is a heavy weight, this is, guys. So I'm really trying to pull in, just going for it at this point. There we go, all in it, just past 90 degrees, yep. And off we go. And again, that looked a lot more painful than I remember, looking back at this footage. But remember, adapting with the stress is the key, and keeping hydrated, as you can see, is obviously very important. So supersetting with leg extensions, and we're just blasting through these. Contraction is decent, nothing absolutely crazy, but the contraction is pretty good. Going for it, just really going for it. Sometimes, guys, just blast it over, man. Rep after rep after rep after rep. And remember, keeping the intensity high is the absolute key. 3 sets on everything, guys, here. Really make sure that that threshold is being pushed. See you next time. I'm your host.